package, okay? So what is the meaning of package? So it's a very simple question. On your PC, you'll be having the folders. What are the folder? You can say that it contains many subfolder, several files. Okay? So similar ways in package, when we talk about the package in Java, so it will be contains, it is the like containers for the classes, and that will be used to keep the class name space. So you can keep as many classes you want, and you can store the several classes in that. You can use that class into the different program using the package. Okay, so we'll be seeing with help of your interface. So there is the keyword that is the interface, so we will be using that also. Okay, so let's go through this and we will understand how to define the package, how to define the class path, how to execute the package, okay, program. So these things is the first our priority, so we should know about this. Okay, so when we talk about the package, so as I said, package is nothing, it's a group of classes, interface, and other packages. So also you can keep sub packages in that. You can have number of classes, okay, you can have interface also, and several packages you'll be having. Okay, so package, especially in Java, it is categorized into two different form. So what are the two different form? That is, one is built-in package and one is user-defined package. So built-in package, that is already predefined, it's already created, okay, and user-defined, that means what we are going to create, you all know very well, that means it's clear user-defined, that is user is going to define the package. Okay, so already you are using several built-in package you have used, like lang java.lang, okay, .io, that is also one of the package. Okay, so that are the those are called as built-in. User defined, we are going to see about the how we can create the user defined package. Okay, so as I said, built-in package is nothing, it's your such as Java, lang, AWT, JavaX, Swing, Net, IO, util, SQL, etc. So there are so many built-in package available, and already we have used in several program. So might will be writing, right? So import java.io.star. So this is also one of the package which you are importing. So this is called as your built-in package. We are using applet programming. In that we need AWT, Applet Window Toolkit. So for that also we are using the predefined, that is the built-in package we are using. So these are the built-in package. Now we will talk about the user-defined package. Okay, so we should know also what is the advantage of package and why we are going to create the package. Okay, so generally it will be categories of your classes, interface, so you can easily maintain. So what happen, you can have separate class. Okay, so suppose you have a 10,000 lines of programming, okay, and you have in the 10,000 lines, you should take examples, you have some, or take minimum 1,000 lines of code, in that you have 10 classes. So to understand all 10 classes, it will be, you feel sometimes, okay, it's very difficult to find it. So what you can do, you can categorize the classes. So you can create each pack class into different package. So it will be easily maintained, and you can call whichever the class you want into the program, you can do that. This is the one big advantage in Java for the creating the package. So you can use, that's why it is called as reusability. So you can use that class anywhere in the program, wherever you want, whichever package you want. So that is the advantage of the package. So provides access protection also. That means obviously you have already gone that about the protection, right? So we have gone through about the encapsulation, right? So it will be your package, will the information is hidden from outside of the different class, right? So that is the also the protection is available. So now the question is that before proceeding to the program, so the package, this is the one keyword, okay? This, remember guys, this package, P-A-C-K-A-G-E, package is the keyword which will be used to create the package in Java. So using that you can create the package. So what is the syntax for creating the package? You are going to write package and package name semicolon. So how you are going to write? So let's create one small program, then we will get to know that how to create the complete package, like creating the package, that means you call as a defining package, then you will find the package path, then class path, and how you are going to execute this package program. Okay, so let's jump to the package programming. So I will today I will give you the idea about how you can create using command prompt, because in Eclipse you will be having already features to create the package. So I'll just show you the Eclipse. If you see the Eclipse, if you go to the file menu, new, okay, so you can see that you have the option called package. So using the any GUI tools, either you use NetBeans, either you use Eclipse, you'll be having the package. You can create it directly. So when select, it will ask you the source folder name and you can proceed. So this I will tell you later. First we should know using the command prompt how to create the package, how to access that, and how to execute. Okay, so hope you all guys remember that we have created, take example that we have created a folder. Okay, so I'll move that all previous program into some other folder. Wait. Okay, so I'll come to here. Okay, so first of all, what we need to write one small program. Okay, so you are going to write a small Java program in which you have to just display method. I am going to just a very simple to understand. Okay, so what is the method first? So this is your folder. Okay, so in this folder I will be creating one Java file. I'll create two Java file. Okay, for both Java file I'll be creating the package and then I will be executing the program. Okay, so we know that we need notepad to write the coding. Okay, so I'll use the create a notepad file. Okay, so definitely we not require txt file. Okay, you all know very well. Okay, so what is the first line? Okay, so the first line is say that package name. So you have to give package. You can give any package name whatever you want. It is not defined that no, you should write only these things. So you can write whatever you want. Okay, so I will write the package name as a CSC. Okay, and then after I'll give semicolon. Okay, so this is how the first step, that means you are creating the package. Okay, after this what you are going to do, we know that we have to create the class. So in Java, the best practice to write the program, you have to use the public keyword in any of the classes, any classes. Wherever you use the class, you create with the public. Okay, so I'll write public, okay, class, okay, then class name. So you can write the class name, anything, whatever you want, A, B, C, test one, okay. So anything I'll write, let's see that I'll write test, or better we'll go with the simple A. Okay, so I am creating a class name A. You know very well we have to give opening and closing brace. Okay, so this is first we have created the class. Okay, Now what we want here? We want here a method. So any class will be having the data and member function both. So whatever you want the functionality, you can use here. So what I'm going to do here, I'll create a method here. So I'll create public, okay, method name. So you are going to write, so method name can be anything, you know very well. So then you have to use return statement. So I have given the keyword as a public, then return statement I'll be using void, then I will be using any method, okay. So you can write anything, m1, m2, just I'm going with the very basic example so you will understand. I will write m1 only, okay, or you can use, you want anything, display, show, whatever you want. Okay, let's go with the display. Okay, so this is one function. Okay, okay, so in this function what you are going to, that means method, what you are going to do, you are going to display. So how to display? You all know very well, to display we have to use printing statement. So that is Java printing statement is system.out.println, okay, and in this I am going to write welcome to package class. Okay, finished. Okay, this is the method finished, class is over. Okay, so what you are going to do, you have to save this program, right? So how you are going to save, you know very well, when you are writing using command prompt, go to file, so you have to use all, and here you have to give the class name. What is the class name you have given? A. So we'll write a.java. okay, so this is the first step is over. So you can see here a.java is created. So now this is the one file we have created. Now what we have to do, we have to create now package. Okay, so how to create the package? Okay, so let's proceed. So what we have to do now, the second step is that you have to open the command prompt in this path only. You should not use like bin or any other folder. Wherever you have your Java program is there, that location, that path only you are going to create the, use the command prompt. So you know very well, you can go to the start run command also. Everyone are, you are using Windows 10. Okay, so directly if you click on file menu, okay, so here actually you will get, actually it will be coming here PowerShell. Okay, so this is also like command prompt. Okay, so leave it, we'll use directly from the command prompt. So just go to the type, go to run, type cmd. okay, so I have come to the command prompt. Okay, so what we have to do, we have to change the directory. What is the directory? Where is the directory? This is the directory. Okay, so I'll change this directory to, okay, so now directory is changed. Or even if you are writing the program any other location, you can change accordingly, right? So this is the step. Now earlier what we used to do, we used to directly compile and execute, but here we are not going to compile. What we are going to do, we have to create the package. So to creating the package, there is the command. What is the command? Java C, okay, a space, okay, then you are going to use minus D. Remember guys, this is the command to create the package, a space, then the path of your Java program. So what is the path you are using, which path your Java program is there, that path you have to give. Okay, so which is the path already just we have taken, so this is our path of Java program. Okay, so then the path, obviously inside this folder only we have, what is the file name, that is the A. What is the class name we have given? The class name we have given a.java. That is file name is a.java. Okay, after that you have to give enter. So once you give enter, what is the problem? See, user this. Option source file. Okay, sorry guys, there was a mistake. Okay, so what you have to do, see the command, you have to use, again I'll repeat, Java C minus D space the path, okay, space, okay, that means you have to give the, that is the path, then space give the file name. Okay, the moment you give the file name, you can see here in the folder we got the package name as CSE. So what package name we have given in the program, we can see the package name we have given as a CSE. So package CSE is created, that means a folder is created. Okay, what is there inside this package? So you know very well that the Java C used for creating, it will convert into the dot class file. Okay, when you open that, definitely there will be a dot class file will be there. Okay, so how many classes you have, all the classes classes will be there into the that particular package. Okay, so this is the first step, we have created the package. Okay, now second step will go. So what is the second step? Now in second step we'll create another program. Okay, and we will import this package. So what we have created, now we will import. So to import, again what you have to do, first we'll create another package. Okay, so we are going to create a new package. So same way creating this, it will be package space package name. So I'll giving as a package name as a CSC1. Okay, enter. So now what you have to do, we want to use the CSC package into this Java program. So we know very well that we have to use the syntax as a import, right? Then only we can import the package from this class, whatever they are into CS, it will be used here. So I'll be using here as a command import. So how we use, you know very well that we have to use package name next. So what is the package name? I have used CSC. Now generally after that what we use, dot star and semicolon. If you all remember import java.io.star. So similar way, what is the meaning of dot star? So whatever the classes available inside the CSC package, that all will be get imported here. So we can use all the classes which is available into the CSC package. Okay, so this is the for creating the package. So I have created the package now. So I am, what we have to now, we have to create here main method, because I want to use the particular class which is available into the this package into the CSE1 package. So it's where again we have to create another class. So same way I'll use public class, and you can give any class name. So previously we have given the class name as A, I will give this to understand very simple B. Okay, now what you have to do, similar way opening and closing brace. Then I need here to use main method. So how to write the main method? You know very well, public static void main. A string arguments, okay. Then what you are going to do, because just now we have created the main method, okay. Now what we want, we have to call the package, right? So what you do, you know very well, we have to create the object. So for which class we have to create, that is the class is A. If you remember the previous program, we had the A as a class name. So A dot, I'll create the object, okay. Object is equal to new class name, okay. So this how we have created the object now, okay. After the creating object, what you have to do, we have to call the method which is available into the a1.java. So what is the method I've created? We have created the method as a display, right? What is the method we have created? We have created as a display. So we have to define now, okay. So I'll use object, okay, dot, what is that, display, okay. That's all. Now I'll save this program as a b.java, okay. So I'll use as a b.java, okay. You can see that I have created the b.java. Now this is done. So two steps we have done. Now what we have to do, again you have to create the package, okay. So we'll go to the again command prompt, okay. So you can see, so same way we have to use java c space minus d, okay. Now just you have to change, because the same path we are having, so b dot java, done, right. We have come to the next line. If you see that in the folder, you can see here we got another package, that name is csc1. So package creation is done. Now we have to execute the program. So how you are going to execute, now this is a big question, which program you have to call and how you have to execute. Now we have to see this one. So what you are going to do, obviously you are going to use the main method class, right? So go to the command prompt, okay. So the main method is the b, right? So what I'll do, similar way earlier how we used to use java space, so what is the package name of second class, that is the csc1 dot. So what is the class name, that is we are using b, okay, and give the enter. You can see that, right? We got the output. What is the output? Welcome to package class. Where we have written this one, we have written into the a.java, okay. You see here, welcome to package class. So this how we are going to create the package. So this is the syntax for this way. You can define the package, okay, then you can create the package, then you can access the package with the path, and then you execute the program, okay. So that's what this is, the program is there, okay. Same way compiling, okay. Java C, already I said destination folder, file name dot java, right? So example already is there, right? So running, already I have said you how to run, okay. you have already imported the package, right? So there is a several way to import the package. Okay, just one. Okay, so there are three ways to access the package from outside the package. Okay, so we have used just now, that is the one method. Okay, so what are the other way to import your package? Okay, so you know very well that you will write the import package name dot star, so this way you can import the package. Second method is that you can write import package name dot class name. So what will happen with this? So you know very well dot star means whatever the classes are there into the particular package, it all will be imported. Here package dot class name, that means only particular class is going to import, not all the class will be imported. The third, you have to use fully qualified domain name. Okay, fully qualified name. So what will be the fully qualified name? So we'll use that also, we'll see the one example. Okay, so let's proceed now first meanwhile. Okay, so using the package name dot star, so this already we have seen, right? If we use package dot star, then all the classes and interface of the package will be accessible, but not sub packages. That means inside that there will be one more, if package sub packages you have created, that will be not accessible. Only inside that what are the packages are there, that will be accessible. Okay, the import keyword, you know very well, it is used to make the classes and interface of other package accessible to the current package. So using the import keyword, you are accessing that the package will be accessible to the current package. Okay, so this already you have seen, right? This same program, just we have used in different way, it is there. So you have created a.java package with the pack. Okay, here you are creating the another b.java, that is the package name is my pack. I am importing here package one. When you print, obviously the output of your first, that is a.java package, it will be called here. Okay, so that is the already we have seen this one. Now second way, using dot class name. Okay, so here we, if you import using this, what will happen? Only declared class, so what class name you are specifying, only that class will be accessible, other than it will be not accessible. Remember this. Okay, so same program, if you use what we are doing here, so you can change the same thing as a pack dot a. So just now we wrote the program. Okay, so what you can do, okay, so you just change there import package. Okay, and write, that is the package name, that is the csc dot class name a. So only a will be, you create some other classes also into the a.java, like I will create after this class c into this. So what will happen, only this will be called. Okay, using fully qualified name. So what is the fully qualified name? So it will be only declared the class of the package will be accessible. So it is going to declare the class of the package which is accessible. If you are defining any class which is like protected or private, that will be not accessible. That is the meaning of fully qualified name. So there is no need to import, you can directly use it. Okay, so it need to just use fully qualified name every time whenever you want to access class or interface. Okay, so you can see here, right? So what I have done here, we have created one package, you have another package. Okay, so you can see what we are doing here, just we are writing package name, that is the previous package, import package. Okay, you can see here, so earlier how we used to create the object name, that is the class name, that is a object is equal to new class name. Now we know the fully qualified. That is, we know the pack, that is the package pack is accessible. So directly I can write pack dot A, that is the package A. So in the package A object is created. So you similar way you will write as a pack dot A, and you will use object dot message. The same way, just slightly different is there. So this will be called as your fully qualified name. So there are, these are the three different method to import the package.